Hi children, good morning. In previous episode, we have discussed the multiplication of three digit number with a single digit number, with regrouping and without regrouping. And we have practiced some example problems on multiplication of three digit number by a single digit number with regrouping. Now, we will practice some more problems on the multiplication of three digit number with regrouping in exercise. So let us go to exercise 4.3. So children, the first section in this exercise 4.3 is multiply the following. So now there are two problems are there. We have to multiply these problems. So see the first problem here, they are given a number that is a three digit number. The three digit number is 304. And we have to multiply 304 with 3. So let us start multiplication from ones place. Already we have discussed how to multiply a given number with a single digit number. So now let us start the multiplication from the ones place. That is, first we have to multiply the digit in the ones place with 3. So first we have to multiply the digit in the ones place with 3. So which digit is in ones place? 4 is in ones place. So multiply 4 with 3. So the first step is we have to multiply 3 with 4. That is 3 into 4. So children, 3 into 4, how much we will get? 12. And it is a two digit number. So if we get the product as a two digit number, so cancel the second digit in it. So what is the second digit? 2. So cancel the second digit and carry that second digit under ones place. So this is the ones place. So write the second digit under ones place. And carry the first digit to the next place. So what is the first digit here? 1 is the first digit. And carry the first digit to the next place. So what is the next place after ones place? That is tens place. So carry the first digit to the ones place. So children, now multiply the digit present in the tens place with 3. So multiply the digit present in the tens place with 3. So which digit is present in the tens place? So 0 is present in tens place. So hi children, up to now we have discussed the multiplication of three digit number with a single digit number. And in this multiplication, there are two types. That is multiplication without regrouping and multiplication with regrouping. So already we have practiced so many problems on multiplication without regrouping and also practiced some example problems on multiplication with regrouping. Now let us practice some more problems on multiplication with regrouping in exercise part. So go to exercise 4.3. So children, multiply the following. So children, here are the two problems on multiplication of a three digit number with a single digit number and with regrouping. So let us see the first problem here. So here the given number is 304. So this is a three digit number and we have to multiply this 304 with 3. So 3 is a single digit number. So multiplication of three digit number by a single digit number with regrouping. So let us start. So let us start our multiplication from ones place. So this is, so ones place, this 4 is in ones place and 0 is in tens place, 3 is in hundreds place. So let us start multiplication from ones place as we have done in addition and subtraction. So in multiplication also, we should start multiplication from ones place. So first, we have to multiply the digit in the ones place with 3. So which digit is present in ones place? So 4 is present in ones place. So we have to multiply 4 with 3. So multiply 4 with 3, that is we will get 3 into 4. So 3 into 4, 3 4 jar 12. So 3 4 jar 12. And this 12 is a two digit number. So if the product is a two digit number, then we should not write the whole number here. So we should not write the whole number 12 under here. But if the product is a two digit number, we have to write only the second digit under one's place. So if the product is a two digit number, write only the second digit under one's place and carry the first digit to the next place. So what is the next place? Tens place. So carry the one to the next place, that is one's place. So now again start the multiplication, and we have to multiply the digit in present in the tens place with 3. So which digit? So what is present in tens place? So 0 is present in tens place. Multiply 0 with 3. So multiply 0 with 3, that is 3 into 0. Children, how much? 3 into 0. So 3 into 0, already we have discussed properties of subtraction. In properties of subtraction, if any number is multiplied with 0, again we will get 0. So 3 into 0, 0. And again, if there is a carried number, we have to add that carried number to the product. So the carried number is 1. We have to add that carried number 1 to the product. So 0 plus 1, again we will get 1. So 0 plus 1, if any number is added to 0, again we will get same number. So the answer is 1, write 1 under tens place. So if there is any carried number, we have to add that carried number to the product. So now again start the multiplication with the hundreds place. So what is present in hundreds place? 3 is present in hundreds place. So multiply 3 with 3. So multiply the digit present in the hundreds place with 3. So that is 3 into 3. Children, how much it becomes? 3 into 3. That is equal to 3. 3 jar. How much, children? So 3 3 jar 9. So 3 3 jar 9. So there is no carried number here. So there is no need to add the number to this product. So simply write this 9 under hundreds place. So the answer is 912. So children, in this way, so if the product is a two digit number, write only the second digit under the place and carry the first digit to the next place. And we have to add that carried number to the product. So children, see the next problem here. So in this problem, the given number is 160. So this is a three digit number. And we have to multiply this number with 5. Here 5 is a single digit number. So now let us start multiplication from the ones place. So what is present in ones place? Here 0 is present in ones place. So multiply 0 with 5. So multiply 0 with 5. That is 0 into 5 or 5 into 0. Children, how much it becomes? 5 into 0 becomes 0. So because according to properties of multiplication, if any number is multiplied with 0, again we will get 0. So the product is 0, write 0 under ones place. Because it is a single digit number, there is no need to carry. So if it is a two digit number, then we have to carry the first number to the next place and second digit to its place. So now ones place is completed. Now go to tens place. So multiply the digit present in the tens place with 5. So what is present in the tens place? 6 is present in the tens place. So multiply 6 with 5. So multiply 6 with 5. That is, we will get 5 into 6. 5 into 6. Children, how much? 5 6 jar. 5 into 6, how much? So 5 6 jar 30. 5 6 jar 30. It is a two digit number. So if the product is a two digit number, then what we have to do? So we have to carry. So how we have to carry? So if it is a two digit number, then write the second digit, that is 0. So write the second digit under tens place and carry the first digit, that is 3. So carry the first digit to the next place. So what is the next place? Hundreds. So carry this 3 to the hundreds place. So write 3 here. So we have to carry 3 to the next place. So now we have to add that carried number to the product. Now multiply the digit present in the hundreds place with 5. So which is present in hundreds place? 1 is present in hundreds place. Now multiply 1 with 5. So multiply 1 with 5, that is 5 into 1. 5 into 1. Children, that is 5 1 jar. 5 1 jar becomes how much? 5 1 jar, 5. And there is a carried number here. We have to add that carried number to this product. That is, we have to add that carried number, that is 5 plus 3. 5 plus 3, children, how much it becomes? 5 after 6. So count 6, 7, 8, 3. So the answer is 8. So write 8 under hundreds place. So the answer is 800. So this is the product. So in this way, we have to multiply a 3 digit number with a single digit number by using this carrying, that is grouping. Carrying means, if the product is a 2 digit number, write the last digit, that is the second digit, under its place and carry the first digit to the next place. And we have to add that carried number to the product. Then we will get the answer. And practice some more problems in this section at your home, which are in the PDF. So, okay, children. So, up to now, we have practiced some problems of multiplication of 3-digit number with a single-digit number using grouping. So, now, let us practice some more problems on these multiplications in the exercise 4.3 in section B. So, what is section B? Multiply the following. Again, there are some multiplication. So, there are some problems on multiplication. So, here are the 4 problems. So, let us see the first problem. So, here, there will given a 3-digit number. So, 284. 284, it is a 3-digit number. We have to multiply this 3-digit number with 5. That is, 5 is a single-digit number. So, now, let us start multiplication from ones place. So now we have to multiply the digit in the ones place with 5. So what is present in ones place? So 4 is present in ones place. So first multiply 4 with 5. So multiply 4 with 5, that is 5 into 4. So children, how much it becomes? 5 into 4. So, first multiply the digit present in the ones place with 5. So, 4 is present in ones place and multiply 4 with 5. That is 5 into 4. Children, how much it becomes? 5 4 jar. 5 4 jar, 20. 5 4 jar, 20. And it is a 2-digit number. If product is a 2-digit number, then we have to grouping. That means we have to do carry. So, how we have to carry? So, if the product is a 2-digit number, so here 2 is a first digit and 0 is the second digit. So, now write the second digit, that is 0, under ones place. So, write the second digit, that is 0, under ones place. And carry the first digit, that is 2. And carry this 2 to the next place. So, carry the next digit, that is the first digit, to the next place. The next place is 10. So carry this number 2 to the tens place. And we have to add this carried number to the product. So now do the multiplication with tens place. So what is present in tens place? So 8 is present in tens place. Multiply this 8 with 5. So multiply 8 with 5. That is 5 into 8. 5 into 8. Children, 5 8 jar, how much? So 5 8 jar, 40. So 5 8 jar, 40. So 40, and it is also a 2-digit number. So if the product is a two digit number, then we have to carry. So how to carry? So write the second digit. What is the second digit here? 0. Write the second digit under tens place and carry the first digit. What is the first digit here? 4. So carry the first digit 4 to the next place. So what is the next place? After tens place, 100 is the next place. So carry this 4 to the hundreds place. And we have to add this carried number to the product. So now multiply the digit in the hundreds place with 5. What is present in hundreds place? 2 is present in hundreds place. So multiply 2 with 5. So multiply 2 with 5. That means 5 into 2. 5 into 2. Children, 5 2 jar. How much? So you have to get a fifth table. If the single digit is 5, we have to get fifth table. If the single digit is 4, we have to get fourth table thoroughly. Then only we can do the multiplications. So if you get tables thoroughly, you can easily do the multiplications. So now here we have to get thoroughly the fifth table. So here 5 2 jar, how much? 5 2 jar 10. Here 10 is also a two digit number. So if the product is a two digit number, what we have to do? We have to carry the number to the next place. So what is the next place? Thousands place. And there are no thousands places. Then what we have to do? We have to add the carried number. So what is the carried number here? So there is 4 is the carried number. Add that 4 to the 4. So add that carried number to the 10. So how much we will get? 10 plus 4, 14. So after 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So you have to add the carried number to the product. So 10 plus 4, 14, and it is also a two digit number, but we should not carry this number. Why we should not carry? Because there is no thousands places. If there is no places, then we have to write the whole number under hundreds place. So write 14 under hundreds place. And 1 will be in the thousands place, 4 will be under hundreds place. So that's why write 1 under thousands place. So children, so this is the multiplication. And see the second problem. So see the second problem here. So what is the given number here? 548. So this is a 3 digit number. And what is the single digit number? 4. Now we have to multiply this 3 digit number with the single digit number 4. So that means you should get 4th table thoroughly. Then only you can do this multiplication very easily. So now start our multiplication from 1's place. So first step is we have to multiply the digit in 1's place with 4. So what is present in 1's place? In 1's place 8 is there. So multiply 8 with 4. Multiply 8 with 4. That is 4 into 8. 4 into 8. Children, how much? 4 8 jar. 4 8 jar 32. So it is a two digit number. If the product is a two digit number, then we have to regroup. That means we have to carry. So how we have to carry? If the product is a two digit number, write the second digit, that is the last digit. So 3 is the first digit, 2 is the second digit. Write the second digit 2 under 1's place. And carry the first digit, that is 3. Carry the first digit to the next place. What is the next place? After 1's place, the next place is 10's place. So carry the 3 to the 10's place. And we have to add this carried number to the product. So now again multiply the digit in the tens place with 4. So what is present in tens place? Here 4 is present in tens place. Multiply this 4 with 4. That is 4 into 4. So 4 into 4. Children, how much? So 4 4 jar, how much? 4 4 jar 16. 4 4s are 16. And again it is a 2 digit number. So if the product is a 2 digit number, again we have to write the second digit only. What is the second digit here? 60 is the second digit. Write the second digit 6 under tens place. So children, so what is this 16? So 16 is a 2 digit number. And again, there is a carried number 2. There is a carried number 2. We have to add that carried number to the product. So add the 2 to the product. So add 2. So add 2 to the 16. So if you add 2 to the 16, how much you will get? You will get 16 plus 2. That means 16 after 17, 18. So write 18. Here 18 is a 2 digit number. So it is a 2 digit number. Write the last digit. What is the last digit here? 8. So write 8 under tens place. And carry the first digit to the next place. What is the first digit here? 1. So carry this 1 to the next place, that is 100's place. Children, do you understand? So we have to carry the, that means we have to add this carried number to the product. Here 1 is the first digit, carry the first digit to the 100's place. So now again multiply the digit present in 100's place with 4. What is present in 100's place? 5 is present in 100's place. So multiply 5 with 4. That is 4 5 jar. That is 4 5 jar. 4 into 5. 4 5 jar, children, how much? 4 5 jar? 20. And what is the carried number here? So there is a carried number in 100's place. What is the carried number? 1. And add this 1 to the product. That is 20 plus 1. So if you add 1 to the 20, how much we will get? 20 plus 1. That is 21. 21. So this is a 21. And now there is no need to carry this number. So otherwise, we have to, what we have to do? So carry the last digit. What is the last digit here? So what is the last digit? 1. And what is the first digit? 2. That is 21. And there is no need to carry, because there is no thousands place. There is no digit in the thousands place. Just write whole number under hundreds place. That is 21. Write 2 under thousands place. 1 under hundreds place. So children, if there is no digit in the thousands place, there is no need to carry. Write the 1 under hundreds place, 2 under thousands place. So the answer is 2182. So children, in this way, we have to, if the product is a 2 digit number, carry the second digit under this place and carry the first digit to the next place and add that carried number to the product. Next, see the third problem. So this is the third problem. So the given number is 856. So 856, this is a 3 digit number. And 9 is the single digit number. Now we have to multiply this 856 with 9. So that is, so we have to get the 9th table thoroughly. Then only we can do this multiplication easily. So let us start our multiplication from 1's place. So what is present in 1's place? 6 is present in 1's place. So multiply 6 with 9. Multiply 6 with 9. That is 9 into 6. 9 into 6. Children, 9 6 jar, how much? 9 6 jar? 54. 9 6 jar? 54. And it is a 2 digit number. If the product is a 2 digit number, then what we have to do? So we have to write the last digit, that is write the second digit. What is the second digit here? 4 is the second digit. Write the 4 under 1's place. And carry the first digit. What is the first digit here? 5 is the first digit. Carry the first digit to the next place. So what is the next place here? 5 is the next place, that is the 10th place. So now carry the 5 to the tens place. So now again start multiplication with the tens place. What is present in tens place? 5 is present in tens place. So multiply 5 with 9. Multiply 5 with 9. That is 5 into 9. 5 into 9 or 9 into 5. Children, how much? 9 5 jar, how much? 9 5 jar as 45. 9 5 jar 45. So the product is 45. And we have to add the carried number to this product. So what is the carried number on the tens place? So 5 is the carried number. So that's why we have to add this carried number to the product. So add the carried number 5 to 45. So if you add 5 to the 45, how much you will get? So after 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50. So if you add 5 to the 45, so 50 you will get. And 50 is a 2-digit number. So then what we have to do? So write the last digit, that is second digit. What is the second digit here? 0. So write this 0 under tens place. And carry the first digit. What is the first digit here? 5 is the first digit. And carry this first digit 5 to the next place. What is the next place? Hundreds place. So carry this 5 to the hundreds place. Now again do the multiplication. So with hundreds place, what is present in hundreds place? 8 is present in hundreds place. Now multiply 8 with 9. So multiply 8 with 9. Then how much you will get? 9 into 8. So that is 9 into 8. Children, how much? 9 8 jar, how much? 9 8 jar 72. So 9 8 jar 72. And the product is 72. And we have to add the carried number to this product. What is the carried number here? So 5 is the carried number. Add this 5 to the 72. So add this 5 to the 72. So children, how much will you get? If you add 5 to the 72, after 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77. So the answer is 77. So children, so the answer is 77, but there is no thousands place here and there is no need to carry. Write the 2 digits under hundreds place and thousands place. So write 7 under hundreds place and write 7 under thousands place. So write the whole number here. There is no need to carry because there is no digit after hundreds place. So the answer is 7704. So children, see the fourth problem here. So what is the fourth problem here? Here also a 3-digit number is given, that is 570. And a single digit number is 8. Now we have to multiply this 570 with 8. So here 8 is a single digit number. So we can do this multiplication thoroughly when only you get 8th table. So you should get 8th table thoroughly, then only you will do this multiplication easily. So let us start our multiplication from ones place. So what is present in ones place? 0 is present in ones place. So now multiply this 0 with 8. Multiply 0 with 8. That is 8 into 0. 8 into 0. That is 8 into 0. Children, how much you will get? 8 into 0. 8 0, 0. Because according to properties of multiplication, if you multiply any number with 0, again you will get 0. Again you will get 0. So that's why 8 into 0, 0. So write this 0 under ones place. That is under ones place. So now start multiplication with tens place. So multiplication with tens place. What is present in tens place? 7 is present in tens place. Multiply 7 with 8. multiply 7 with 8. That is 8 into 7. 8 into 7. That is 8, 7 jar. Children, how much 8, 7 jar? 8, 7 jar? 56. 8, 7 jar? 56. And it is a 2-digit number. And there is no carried number under tens place. And there is no need to add any number to this 56. So now, this is a 2-digit number. Now what we have to do? If the product is a 2-digit number, then we have to carry. So here, write the first digit. Write the second digit. What is the second digit here? 6. So write 6 under tens place. And carry the first digit. What is the first digit here? 5. Carry this first digit 5 to the next place. What is the next place? Hundreds place. So carry this 5 to the next place. That is hundreds place. So now again do the multiplication with hundreds place. What is present in hundreds place? 5 is present under hundreds place. Multiply this 5 with 8. Multiply 5 with 8, that is 8 into 5. 8 into 5, that is 8 5 jar. Children, how much? 8 5 jar, how much? 8 5 jar, 40. 8 5 jar, 40. And again, there is a carried number 5 under hundreds place. So if there is a carried number, then we have to add that carried number to the product. So what is the carried number here? 5. Add 5 to the 40. Add 5 to 40. How much you will get? So if you add 5 to 40, after 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45. So write 45. So children, here 45 is a 2-digit number and there is no need to carrying because there is no digit present in thousands place. So if there is no digit after hundreds place, write the whole number 45. That is, write the 2-digit number under hundreds place. So that is, write 5 under hundreds place and write 4 under thousands place, and there is no need to carry because there are no thousands. So write the 2 digits at a time under hundreds place and thousands place. The answer is 4560. So children, in this way we have to do the multiplication with regrouping, that is with the carry.